Good afternoon. A major victory for a DNA collection law in New Mexico and across the U.S. The Supreme Court has ruled that swabbing DNA of people arrested for felony crimes is constitutional. The law started in New Mexico, and it's known as Katie's Law. Now the family that helped create it thinks the law will finally spread to all 50 states. News 13's Chris McKee has more.
This means so much to our family.
10 years after the rape and murder of Katie Sepich in Las Cruces, Katie's mother, Jayanne Sepich, is confident what happened to her daughter won't happen to thousands of other people, as a law made in Katie's honor will continue.
We're just jubilant that the Supreme Court has said that taking DNA upon arrest is constitutional.
In a 5-4 ruling Monday, the Supreme Court upheld Katie's Law and similar laws in 25 other states, allowing them to swab DNA from people arrested for felony crimes. Governor Martinez, who helped pass Katie's Law, praised the ruling.
It's a huge victory, and it's a huge victory for victims of crime to make sure that we are prosecuting and convicting the right people and exonerating the right people.
Katie Sepich was killed in 2003 by Gabriel Avila. He was only connected to Katie's death when DNA from under Katie's fingernails was entered into a national database for another crime Avila was convicted of, which happened after Katie was killed.
We know that arrestee DNA can save lives.
Sepich says the law would have also saved a Nevada woman, Brianna Dennison.
It would have identified her murderer as a rapist before he had the chance to rape and murder her.
Sepich believes the law will spread soon. The federal government passed law in January giving states funding to start DNA databases.
With the federal funding available and with the Supreme Court giving it the thumbs up saying it is constitutional, I really do believe over the next 2 or 3 years the remaining states will pass arrestee DNA laws.
For Jane, the ruling is a lasting tribute to her daughter.
It means that other families will be spared losing their daughters, and there's nothing more important to us than that.
Chris McKee, KRQE News 13.
Jayanne Sepich says she's already heard from legislators and sponsors in other states without Katie's Law. She believes the law will pass soon in Wisconsin, Pennsylvania, Connecticut, Georgia, and Indiana.